I've been standing here on this corner with this brown bag in my hand. And you'd be surprised to find out what I learned about myself and my fellow man. Now you can ask any successful man, black, yellow, red, brown, or white. And if he's honest with you, he's gonna tell you what I'm telling you is right. With all kinds, we got winners, and y'all, we got losers. Some rich that seems broke, and some are wealthy that seems poor. Some wrong and don't know it, and some right and won't show it. So you're blessed if you can recognize that very rock of a man that does the very best he can. And some of all races and groups of all people, we got some of them that cop out and make many excuses. And sometimes we lay it on our race, not saying it's not difficult. Some blacks blame it on being black. And have you ever thought of all poor people ain't black, and all black people ain't poor? But have you ever thought maybe you ain't black? Listen, were you the blackest one in your all-black school? Did even the lighter members of your own race point all the black jokes at you? And when you wouldn't be there pats and fought back cause you were sick of that mess, did they call you a bad sport and say you had an inferiority complex? Did this ever happen to you? Well, then maybe you ain't black. Did the girls ever tell you, step back, black cat, you can't shine, I got a yellow cat to beat your time? This didn't happen to you? Well, then maybe you ain't black. Maybe what you think is real ain't real. You ought to sit back and start listening how a black person really feels. If things have changed so much with us today, why do I still see the light and dark of our own race going separate ways? By teaching the black to hate the white, don't you know you're teaching the dark to hate the light? And if you've done all you could today, get you some rest, cause there's more to do tomorrow. You know, sometimes we get frustrated because we don't have a plan. And one of the main reasons we can't get what we think we want is because we really don't know definitely what we really want. But we gotta beat that. And sometimes we adhere to the mother of violence, which is fear. Show me a violent man and I'll show you a man who's frustrated and scared to death. And he's scared of two things. Scared that something or someone will keep his life from being the way he wants it, or he's afraid that he don't have the mental capacity to overcome those obstacles. And sometimes it's not anything outside the person, it's what's inside him that's holding him back. It reminds me of the story of the boy and his dog. You see, a little boy tied his dog to a pole, but he didn't tie it well. And while he was playing with his friends, the rope came loose and fell. And the dog really wanted to play, but instead he howled and cried. And he stayed right there in the very same spot, because he thought he was tied. As the little boy came back, saw the rope loose and all, he patted his pet on the head and said, "You're a good dog." But the boy, being the master, he had fun and was satisfied. And the dog could have too, but he thought he was tired. As I look at the servants and the masters of men, y'all, I see that same story happening over and over, time and again. Some build and use their minds and they are being satisfied, and others are standing still and confused and crying because they think they are tired. Well, almost done told y'all now. Done told you to bed. And you gotta go on out there and do the rest. But I found out people hear what they want to hear, when they want to hear it, why they want to hear it, where they want to hear it, and from who they want to hear it from. Almost done told y'all now. Done told you the best. It's up to you. You gotta go on out there and do the rest. I'm gonna be seeing you.